Hello YouTubers, and welcome to this tip or thought for the day. So I quickly wanted to post this before I jumped in and did all my work this morning, being Monday, in terms of going through all your comments and the forum or what have you. Thanks very much for the feedback on the two videos posted on the testing of the fuses. I really think your comments are actually more valuable than the videos themselves, because in essence the video is a catalyst of my kind of thinking and testing, but the pearls of wisdom and information which you guys have brought out has been brilliant, and I hope to kind of pull that all together in the last video in part 3, where hopefully I'll actually bring in some more realistic true information about the fuses, both from the testing that I've been doing and the information that you've been putting in there. So thank you very much. So first of all, what you would have noted in the little entry clip to the video, fortunately I didn't blow the fuses in both my Agilent, my Fluke 287 and my Metrics. My Metrics happens again, is still behind you. I'm still running some testing on the batteries with a new battery charger, which I'll talk about in a moment. I could have blown the fuses quite easily, but again, that's part and parcel of the testing that I do. If I happen to do something in ignorance like that, then rather learn from my mistakes and I'll learn from it and we'll all be the wiser. But both, all of them managed to survive. But case in point, the interesting thing would be to know what the inrush current was. And of course, there's a lot of feedback there in terms of perhaps using an oscilloscope and a shunt to pick that up, because obviously it would be measuring very quickly. I've got something else which I totally forgot about, which might be able to do the job, and that's my Fluke 43B. Plus I've got a DC clamp, current clamp. So it should do it. I don't, unless even the speed of the fuse blowing is too quick for this, but I'm gonna give it a bash, but this might work. If not, I'll again try my Fluke 287, but with a current shunt this time. And if that doesn't work, well, it'll have to be something that's safe when I do have a working oscilloscope to actually do that test. Then again, just a reminder for those of you who don't already know or haven't seen this multimeter, remember the Mastech MS8218, the 50,000 count with very good accuracy, is up for grabs for the end of November. I'll post the link to the in my forum below where the entry details are there. So remember, that is still available for the end of November. Then the other thing I wanted to bring to your attention quickly is that Andre from Victron Energy, besides, I say I'm still busy, I've got a video which has been posted which they're just reviewing at the moment. This is part 2 of the battery monitor. But he has now given me 3 of the Victron Energy car battery chargers. So to test and play with, and then I'm ultimately going to do a review slash tutorial on these as well for Victron Energy. Now these are interesting, and I've got one on test at the moment where, because they do a proper 4-stage charging of a battery. So I'm busy doing that with my metrics, because my metrics can actually graph what's going on, because I want to see those 4 stages and how well they work. So that'll be something we look at. So to end off, this is just a quick short segment, just because before I jumped in, I wanted to thank you guys obviously for your feedback. I'm going to try now jump in and answer all your comments. Generally speaking, it takes me anywhere between 1 to 4 hours a day to go through all the communications that I get, because I attempt to get through everything. I probably reply to 99% of the comments, emails, forum posts which are sent to me. But that I know is not going to be sustainable going into the future, because there's just going to be too much. I'll spend far too much time working on communications as opposed to prepping and doing videos. So I will always try and get round to most of it, but please, I hope you're not offended if I can't get round to all the comments. I'll try and, you know, over time get through to most of you. Now, just for a laugh, just to end off the video as something entertaining, I said I'm getting to that point where my channel is just about reaching the cusp where it might kind of sustain me. And again, I thank all of you very much for that. but just a bit of entertainment about what people can do and how people can make money out of YouTube on posting videos on YouTube. I've obviously got a second channel, Vlog Mag, which I, unfortunately I don't get a lot of time to dedicate to because most of my time comes here. But I do a bit of research in terms of understanding what content attracts people and channels. And sometimes you come across these channels and just think, my goodness, how on earth does someone draw in so many people and they must be making heaps of money? So just to put it in perspective, I'm going to post the link here to the channel homepage of someone called Jenna Marbles. Now, I don't know if any of you have heard of her before. Just click on the link up here to her channel homepage and go and look at the number of subscribers she has and the number of video views overall. Now, when I checked this morning, she had well over 4.6 million subscribers, and she's got like 800 and something million video views. When she posts a video, she gets about 2 million views within a couple of days, and over a month she'll get 8 million views. Now, currently, my channel over a month gets about, is approaching about 140,000 views across all my videos in a month, and I'm just about to sustain myself. It's just unfathomable. If you go and look at the content and what she's talking about, go and watch a few of her videos, how on earth she can draw that much attention, how you can make money like that on YouTube. It just blew my mind. Just for entertainment, if you want a distraction, go and have a look. It's quite an education. I should have been blonde and chosen another topic to talk about, I think, if I really wanted to make good money. But anyway, I thank you very much for your support. What I am going to do today as well, once I've got through the communications, I'm going to start pick up on the electronics tutorials again. We're going to start with, now we're going to get into electronic components. So it's going to be diodes, Zener diodes, triacs, 555 timers, capacitors, and all that kind of thing. So I'll do try and we'll do a little theory analogy of the component, and then if possible, I'm going to try and do a practical application as well, like I did before. Okay, so look forward to that. Thank you, and I'll catch you soon. Cheers.